Hello and welcome to Living Black, coming to you from Nooka in the Roper River region of the Northern Territory. I'm Carla Grant. In today's program, defending the homelands, NT traditional owners prepare for a political showdown.
First and foremost, I am my land.
What impact could a new law in Queensland have on the traditional hunting of dugong and turtle?
Practices that we're practicing today, it's part of our identity.
And we look at the Film of the Year nominations for the Deadly Awards.
I'm taking the government to court to get our land.
People like us, we can't afford to be troublemakers.
Here in the Northern Territory, homelands are areas where Aboriginal people live a traditional lifestyle. But the future of these outstations is now under threat. Alan Clark investigates.
They're going to normalise us. To normalise us means to take away my identity. I then become a carbon copy of the mainstream and stripped of who I am.
A passionate voice, desperate to save the most important part of Aboriginal culture. The ability to live on traditional lands, known as homelands or outstations.
But Bardi, where are my people? Mina says I should go walk about and learn the customs of my tribe.
As a young Aranda woman, Rosalie Kunath Monks was plucked from her Utopia homelands in 1955 and thrown into a Technicolor dream, landing the role of Jeddah in Jeddah the Uncivilized. Today, she's on a very different stage. Fronting Amnesty International's campaign, There's No Place Like Homelands.
On Yirrkala the day they told us that we might have to leave for jobs and so forth. It was incredible how many people said, shoot us now.
Rosalie wants continued federal support for the sustainability of the more than 500 homelands in the Northern Territory. It's a highly charged and emotive issue, triggered by the new Working Futures Policy, a Northern Territory government initiative, which will transform 20 Aboriginal communities into real townships.
Growth town is where you're dislocated from the land that your ancestors have held for thousands of years.
This is one of the growth towns, Gullawinku on Elko Island in Northern Arnhem Land. A new suburb full of new houses has sprung up amidst the scrub. But just a short drive away and conditions are very different. The Gullawara homeland is Nyumba's land. She says that while Gullawinku is growing, her small community stagnates.
Homeland is more important than growth land, where the township is.
Gullawara is home to generations of Nyumba's family. Accommodation is basic. One house and several tents. Clean running water comes from a tap outside. But Nyumba has a vision for her homeland's future. A family-owned eco-tourism business. 7 years ago, she submitted a business proposal to the federal government for funding, but she's still waiting on an answer.
The government always doesn't see and realise that we people, that we've got a vision and dream for our land.
Amnesty International says that more than 30% of Aboriginal Territorians live on outstations, and that they have better health, are less likely to drink or take drugs, and rates of violence are lower. The benefits aren't just social. Enterprise connected to homelands is worth more than $750 million each year to the NT economy. In last month's Northern Territory elections, the Country Liberal Party won an historic landslide victory over Territory Labor.
And they have sent this party a message.
Many Aboriginal voters turned their backs on Labor to support the CLP's stable of Indigenous candidates and their support for the homeland. But despite millions of dollars in election year promises, there are those who remain sceptical.
Want to see things, a vehicle given to us straight away and a health nurse given to us straight away. We've been asking for 10 years now. Can't give them, can't really give up.
David lives on the Yirrapunga homeland in the Roper River region. He refuses to move and says that all he wants is access to the same services as the rest of Australia has. Fearing a medical emergency, wheelchair-bound David tells me there is a health clinic here, but it has no staff.
If I fall down off the wheelchair or something, I hurt myself, I might drop dead. That's not good enough.
The Commonwealth Government has pledged $220 million, but it's only for basic utilities, not for much-needed housing. Even so, the voices of protest have not been silenced. 18-year-old Amelia Kunath Monks has joined her grandmother in defence of the homeland.
It feels like it's the final solution to get rid of all Aboriginal people and get them into not growth towns but concentration camps, as Hitler did with the Jews.
The voice of a new generation willing to take up the fight for the right to live life on ancient ground.
And that was the second of a three-part series on social issues confronting the NT. In his final report next week, Alan Clark investigates an enterprising way of ending welfare dependency. Still to come on Living Black, what impact could a new law in Queensland have on the traditional hunting of dugong and turtle?